Paltrocast.
Coolio, an honor and a pleasure. Just been a fan of yours for like 25-ish years now. So thank you for taking the time. Good day for you so far?
Absolutely. Every day above ground is a good day, brother.
Oh, man. That's deep. That's deep. Well, how did the opportunity to work with the Hormel people come about?
Actually, they reached out to me, and they thought it was a perfect marriage because of my affinity for, you know, being in the kitchen. I am a self-taught gourmet chef. You know, they call me the ghetto gourmet, and I can make a chicken come back to life and grow new feathers and crip walk across any stage on the planet.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you did have a cookbook. You did have Cooking with Coolio, per se. So from a young age, you were into cooking and food prep?
Well, my mom was a taskmaster, so to speak, to put it mildly.
Yeah.
One day I burnt a pencil in the wall heater, set it on fire, and it got scared and dropped it. It burnt the carpet a little bit. And then I proceeded to, so that was one thing I wasn't supposed to do. I was about eight years old.
Yeah.
And then I went into the kitchen, and I was supposed to make myself a tuna sandwich for lunch. And I did, but I decided that I wanted a tuna melt. So I got a pan out of the cabinet, mm-hmm. and put it on the stove, which I was not supposed to do because I wasn't supposed to touch the stove. And I melted some cheese on it and made myself a tuna melt. Now, there was nothing wrong with that if I would have cleaned the pan.
Oh.
I was a kid. So I took the pan and threw it in the sink like any man would do. Mistake, bad mistake. That caused me to get a semi-terrible ass whooping. And because of that, about 2 weeks later, I was sitting there watching cartoons. My mother was in the kitchen, slaving over that hot stove, doing all the prep, chopping. She was chopping some, she needed to chop some celery, some onion, some yellow onion, and some green onion, some spring onion. And then slice some carrots.
Mm-hmm.
And she was not happy about doing it all herself. So I could always feel my mother staring at me. And I felt her staring at me. And I did not like to look when I knew she was staring. So she said, mm-hmm. She started talking under her breath. Excuse my French, motherfuckers want to cook. And my kids cooking and shit, using pans. And, She said, come here. She said, all right. I said, huh? She said, come here. She said, here, take this knife. She said, now, she said, I'm going to show you how to chop this onion. I'm going to show you how to chop up the celery. She said, I'm going to show you how to do it the right way. She said, if you cut yourself, she said, I will take you to the hospital. But she said, I'm going to beat your ass first. She said, so you better do it right. So she taught me how to chop an onion, taught me how to chop celery, and she taught me how to use a knife. Basically, she taught me how to, gave me my first lesson in knife skills. And from then on, I did all the prep in my house, all of it.
Wow. Do you have a specialty dish? If somebody says, make the thing that you make the best, do you have a clear answer to that?
I got a couple, bro. Actually, it depends on what they want. Now, if they want beef, I will make them a fork steak. A fork steak is a steak that's so tender, you can cut it with a fork. You don't even need a knife. Or I could make them, if they want chicken, I can make them soul rolls, or I can make them fall off the bone and into your mouth chicken, or I can make them my wings fly over Vegas. Or, you know, it just depends on what they want. I can make them while you bean on my thigh. man.
I see what you did there, but of course, all those dishes have Hormel bacon in them, correct?
Oh, well, not all of them, but now here's the thing. Because of my vast array of skills,
yeah,
and my supreme kitchen knowledge, I can turn bacon back into an actual pig.
That's talent. Wow. Well, if speaking of talent, you know, I mentioned up top here, you know, fan of yours. When I said 25 years, I was wrong because Fantastic Voyage was more than 25 years ago. MTV played the hell out of that video.
It's about 30 years, right?
Loved it. Is
it 28 years or 30 years?
Whatever that number is, I don't want to know right now. But but the key is, I thought that you were always ahead of the curve with your career choices. And by that, I mean, you were doing reality TV before a lot of musicians and rappers were doing it. You had the cookbook and you were doing the celebrity chef thing first. You were on the high profile soundtracks before a lot of artists knew to do that kind of stuff. How much of that has been good management versus you saying, yeah, I'll say yes to anything that sounds fun?
Nah, it's been actually some good management and some just being in the right place at the right time. And, you know, being accessible, you know, I think that, and then just having an open mind to things and being somebody that wants to do different things, I think. And I think that's probably the most part of it. I always wanted to be open to do all kinds of things because I do all kinds of things. I mean, you know, 85 jobs.
Yeah.
But I got a concept called 85 jobs. The more things you know how to do, the more likely it is that you will never be broke.
Well, sure. But as big as you've been here in the States, it's always been even bigger in Europe, per se. So you knew early on, hey, that German market is like the number three market in the world. You were ahead of the curve there, too.
But what it is, I won the World Music Award. When I won the World Music Award, I think the World Music Award is absolutely more important than the Grammy. Because the Grammy the Grammy is recognized worldwide, mm-hmm. but a lot of Europeans, especially in the eastern part of Europe and in the non-English speaking countries, they don't give a damn about the Grammy, some of them. And yeah. that thing is the World Music Award or the MTV Awards. So I think, yeah, you're absolutely right.
Yeah, I always was reading about, hey, Coolio is the star of this new thing in Germany. And they're like, oh, he either knows something that we don't know. Well, now we know you knew. And another accolade of yours is, I would say you were the first superstar rapper to kind of get in with the Insane Clown Posse, or at least one of the first. So your affiliation with ICP was also really smart. So it seems like you're pretty easy to work with.
Well, you know what? I'm gonna tell you, it's a blessing and a curse, all of these things you said. Because while being somebody that kind of could see the future a little bit or kind of, you know, anticipated things, mm-hmm. I also was, I think I was too far ahead of my time. Yeah, because I was doing, even my choice in musical tracks and my choice in music, I think I was so far ahead of my time that people didn't understand me. I think they didn't get me all the time, you know?
I hear what you're saying there. With most of your huge hits, they had samples that I didn't hear sampled before that. You were ahead of the curve, I thought, in sampling Kool & the Gang, Stevie Wonder, et cetera. Was that you, or did you have a really good producer who went, check out this vinyl?
Well, some of it was me, and then I had a really couple of really good producers, but mostly being my main producer, who actually the person who invented my, well, let me see, who helped me find my sound. Mm-hmm. Let's just say he made my sound. DJ Wino, better known as Brian Dobbs. Have you ever heard of Razzcazz?
Yes.
Okay, he was Razzcazz's very first producer. A lot of people don't know that. He made Razzcazz's first demo, which was, he had a song on there called The Black of the Berry, The Sweet of the Juice. They were all very pro-black songs, or, you know, and they were in the vein of, BDP or Public Enemy-ish.
Sure. When
it was
Afrocentric, you can say nationalistic.
Afrocentric, I don't really like that word. They're trying to say something, make a statement. Help me. You know what I'm trying to say? Okay, he was
outspoken.
No. That's not it. it's a word for it. Not woke. Huh? No. Anyway, it'll come to me. Yeah. So his songs were that was the mainstream then. Mm-hmm. Being intelligent or rapping about positive things at that time was more the mainstream. And like now, being dumb and rapping about negative things is mainstream.
I hear what you're saying. Yeah, the Brian Dobbs that you just mentioned, there's either two Brian Dobbses who did production, or is that the Brian Dobbs who worked with David Lee Roth a couple of years before you?
No, it's two different ones.
So there's two different Brian Dobbs.
Yeah, this Brian Dobbs is from the West Coast. Actually, he's DJ Wino. He also was my DJ when I first came out. He had a really good ear for things. He knew a lot of music, and, you know, he knew a lot of the old school stuff, and he wasn't afraid to try different things.
Yeah. The reason I was curious about your samples is another great MC that I've had the pleasure of interviewing, Young MC. Some of his early hits sampled Kiss and Van Halen. So I was interviewing him and I said, so when you sampled Kiss and Van Halen, was that you? You know, were those your influences? Like, I had nothing to do with that. That was all the label. They told me what to do. But in your case, you chose the stuff.
Yeah, my label, they didn't have any type of, well, I don't want to say not any type of creative control, but yeah, they weren't very proactive.
Proactive, so to speak. Yeah.
All they did was want to remix everything. Tell me why you always tried to act like my tracks weren't good enough and have somebody go and do some revamp version, like Fantastic Voyage. They had this cat come in and do some revamp version of a Fantastic Voyage, and my battery's about to go dead. Bruh, I need a battery right now.
Hello.
Look, super low.
I don't know, you got
okay. Anyway, man, my charger's here somewhere. It's ridiculous. I don't know where it is. I just bought a brand new laptop, and this is the second time that I haven't been able to find my charger. Anyway,
technology, man. But did they make you do any rock remixes? Did that happen where they went, "Hey, Coolio, metal band, do it"? So no rock remixes.
They were not. Tommy Boy was pretty. I want to say they weren't very creative. They weren't creative when it came to the music. Their thing was marketing. There was a guy at Tommy Boy named Albie Ragusa. Mm-hmm. He was a marketing genius, but because he was in marketing, they weren't paying him enough, basically. So he moved to A&R.
Yeah.
After a while, so he could get points on out. It was a mistake because he had a very jaded ear. He was very pro East Coast, and he only liked a certain kind of sound. And he ended up not working for them very long after that. But he was the one that came up with the OPP stickers. He was the one that came up with the OPP t-shirts. He's the one that came up with the Coolio work shirt. Just a lot of stuff. He was a smart dude, and his background came from Wall Street, Tommy Boy. But he was a smart dude, and instead of just paying him more, they moved him to A&R, and he was not a very good A&R, not at all.
Well, either way, again, we were connected by the wonderful Hormel-related folks. What's coming up for you besides, you know, using that great bacon wrapping paper in the near future? Please plug everything you're working on. If we're going to get a new album, whatever it is, I want to hear it.
One, got a new track with Too Short. Got a new track with Corrupt. I got a new track with Chill from Compton Most Wanted. There may be a track with Akon.
Oh.
It's looking good. That's my boy. I'm doing more features than I've ever done in my life. Just because I wanted to do something, because I've never done it. Everybody always does it. And I didn't. So yeah, now
it was always Coolio featuring. Now it's blank featuring Coolio.
No, it's actually cool. It's blank featuring. No, it's Coolio featuring blank.
Okay.
Yeah. So, I didn't have too many features on. I have features on my records, but yeah. I never put them out as singles. So almost every one of my singles, almost every one of them have a feature. My son is featured on a song.
Cool.
Also, I'm going to shoot a video for every song on the record. And I'm not going to put the record out right away. I'm going to drop some singles. I want to say at least 5 to 7 singles before I drop an album. Just because I want to get these youngsters back familiar with my sound. Even though my sound has, you know, taken some curves and some jumped over some hills and, you know, swam through a few oceans and
just a few, you know,
to get where I am now. I think that I'm a lot more thoughtful. When I say thoughtful, not in trying to please everybody. I think I tried to please people more back then. Now I'm a lot more clever, I think. And I still will rap about anything. I have no rap filter. I have no filter when
rap
it comes
filter. To- There's the album title for you right there, Rap Filter.
Actually, my album titles are, I'm playing with this one. Tell me what you think.
Yeah.
Old Man River.
Okay. Like the old standard song right there. Okay. Yes.
Or
Filter, Old Man River, whatever it is, I'm looking forward to that album.
Or how about this? Coming Around the Mountain.
I like that too.
It's gonna be something to make people like, huh? Or hold on, wait for it.
I'm waiting.
And I played with this turtle some years ago when I was on Tommy Boy. I think when I made My Soul, what I really wanted to call the album was The Last Original N-Word.
Now, I won't be able to say that album title, but you'll get a lot of press off of that album title. So never say never.
How about you can say this, The Last Original Ninja. And you know, that's how my boy Vanilla Ice says it.
your fellow ICP friend, Vanilla Ice. Well,
and ICP actually, they say ninja too. So
you're not wrong. Well, I can't thank you enough for your time. I'm looking forward to that new music and glad to see that you're not stopping anytime soon, man. Thank you for your time and have a great rest of the day.
Hey, man, I was born August 1st, 1963. I'm 58 years old. I'm Coolio with the flow, better known as Shaka Zulu.
There you go, man. Have a great rest of the day. Take care, Coolio. Thanks, Steve.
I like your house, Darren. Nice crib.
Long Beach, Long Island, New York. Come over. We'll have you.
Absolutely. Shaka Zulu, man. Take care of yourself. Thanks, man. Paltrocast.